Finally, the TV mode will provide you with the picture from the demodulated signal. There are three submodes as well in the TV mode. In order to change from one submode to another, we need to press the TV mode button. The TV 1 out of 3 submode will show the selected TV service in full screen. TV 2 out of 3 will show the selected service in a smaller window, plus the spectrum analyzer screen on the right and the measurements for the RF channel being tuned below. While in this submode, we can move along the spectrum frequency band by pressing left and right with the joystick. Finally, TV 3 out of 3 submode will provide us with very useful information about the demodulated transport stream and the associated services carried within. Most of the information from the screen TV 3 out of 3 is picked up from the transport stream PSI-SI tables. So if any specific information has not been defined by the broadcaster in the corresponding tables, the meter will show the related field as blank. In this case, we can see in the left window information about the video service, such as the video coding for the selected TV service. The HD Ranger meters are MPEG-2 or MPEG-4 video coding compatible. Other information shown in the same window is the bitrate for the selected video service, its resolution, aspect ratio, scanning rate, compression profile and level, and the video service PID. The upper right window shows us service-related information, for instance, the network name, provider name, network ID, original network ID, transport stream ID, service ID, logical channel number, and it tells us whether the service is encrypted or not, or whether the analyzer has detected any additional interactive service such as hybrid broadcast broadband TV, multimedia home platform, or MHEG5. Finally, the lower right window is providing information about the audio service selected. The HD Rangers are MPEG-1, MPEG-2, high-efficiency AAC, Dolby Digital, and Dolby Digital Plus compatible. We can see in that window the audio coding for the selected audio service, its bitrate, format, sampling rate, language descriptor, audio PID, and whether it's mono or stereo. F1, F2, and F3 keys will give us access to the same menus as in the spectrum and measurement modes. However, F4 is now different and allow us to check any of the available audio tracks for the specific service we are watching on the screen. We will see as well the URL related to an interactive service if it has been declared accordingly in the corresponding TS table by the broadcaster. In TS data, we will be shown the RRG, Interference Reduction Group data descriptor, as long as the signal being tuned carries this identifier. If it does, which is not the case, we will see a screen like this. The IRG descriptor is an embedded code that is added to some sky-to-ground or ground-to-ground video links, containing contact information and GPS coordinates from the signal source. With this information, the signal source, which may be causing an interference, can be tracked down easily. One very important feature can be accessed by pressing F3 and choosing Select Service. A table will pop up showing all the TV services included in the RF channel we are currently tuning. An icon will inform us of whether the service is TV, radio, or data, whether it is HD or SD, whether it is scrambled or free, and its service ID number. Finally, when pressing F1, if we select View of Services, we will be shown a database listing all the services from all the RF channels we have tuned so far. In this way, we can choose any of them or even find them by filtering, and once one service is selected, the meter will tune automatically the corresponding RF channel that service belongs to. This is a feature that is deactivated by default in the meter. In order to activate it, we need to access to the Preferences menu by long pressing the Folder button. Go to the Tools tab and select the Database Services option.